Hello, welcome to the chapter on signaling with semaphores. Or as Sheldon might put it, fun with flags.
What does flags have to do with semaphores, Scott?
Well, isn't that the name translation for semaphores? It really means flags?
That is true.
That's right. So we're going to talk about semaphores in this chapter. What are we really covering here?
We're covering semaphores, which are also flags.
Flags.
So within the operating system, the ti-rtos, we're going to talk about how do you configure semaphores, how do you create semaphores, and also how do you use semaphores and what the basic use cases are. Really, probably one of the most primary use cases is when you get an interrupt, let's say a timer goes off or some other interrupt in the system, that usually signals a resource is available. So within that interrupt service routine, and if we're using TI drivers, that would be in the callback function itself, we would want to post a semaphore to unblock a task that's waiting to process that data.
So a lot of this has actually been done already in the drivers that we've been using.
Sure.
So Eric, what are we going to do in the lab?
So in the lab, we're going to actually set up a timer resource that is set up to go off every 500 milliseconds. So that's our timing for blinking the LED. That's actually also going to be our trigger for the interrupt. Then once we get the interrupt inside the TI driver, the callback function is going to post the semaphore to unblock the task that blinks the LED.
Okay, so the timer goes to the semaphore, which triggers the task to run.
Correct, and blinks the LED.
Which then blinks the LED. That sounds good. Okay, let's get to it.
Welcome to Chapter 9, Using Semaphores. Okay, the goal of this chapter is pretty simple. What is a semaphore? How do you create one? What are some of the parameters for semaphores? How are they used to unblock tasks and so forth? So really the objectives are to describe what a semaphore is. There's two different basic API. One is a post and one's a pen. How do they work? Compare and contrast the different types of semaphores. There are FIFO versus priority base, as well as counting versus binary. And we're going to take a look at those after the lab. So the lab goal is this. We need to create, because we don't have to, but in this lab, we created a hardware interrupt service routine, and we created a hardware interrupt using a timer. Scott, we actually stole your code from, was that lab 4C?
Yep.
Where you did my timers. So we're using that same exact code to set up a timer that clicks down every 500 milliseconds, and then when it hits zero, there's a hardware interrupt service routine that runs, and as part of the timer driver callback function, we're going to write a semaphore for post of a semaphore, then that unblocks our old task that has a semaphore pen. Remember, prior to that, we had a task sleep for 500 ticks, toggle the LED, and we just kept doing that. Now we're going to take out the task sleep and use the signaling mechanism from the timer driver to the task to unblock it. So that's what we're going to be doing in the upcoming lab. The first topic we're going to talk about is where semaphores fit in. We're basically going to go back to our task topology and kind of reinforce where those semaphores were and how they operate in the signals. Secondly, we'll look at pend and post functions and how they work. Then we'll look at how do you create a semaphore, and then we're going to do a lab. And then the advanced topic is what are the four types of semaphores and when might you want to use one versus the other.